Hi, my name's Samira. Welcome to my channel. Today we will be talking about this year's Victoria's Secret fashion show.
Goatee sitting on a dash, she a rock star. Make your favorite single wanna rap, baby. La la Lisa, can you teach me Japanese? That's it, hype, hype. That's my life, life, baby. I'm a rock star.
She's back!
Yeah.
Okay, well, we know for the past 4 years, Victoria's Secret has stopped their fashion show. And there's been like a lot of controversy surrounding the brand, especially with their reports of transphobia and exclusivity and fat shaming. And as far as I was concerned, I thought we canceled Victoria's Secret. So when I saw like the day of the fashion show, that it was happening, I was like, wait a minute. I thought, okay. But speaking of that, there was not a lot of like, at least from what I've seen, marketing, like leading up to the show. Cause I know like in the past, like 4 years ago, back when you'd have the Victoria's Secret fashion show, it'll be like 2 weeks ahead of time. People will be getting hyped. Like you join like, check Twitter, you join like freaking groups on Reddit. And people would be getting hyped for the show, thinking about, oh, which models are going to be angels? Who's going to do this? Yada, yada, yada. But I didn't hear peep about it till the day of. When I saw, what's her name? Anouk? I saw that video. Actually, I think I might have pronounced that wrong. I think it's Anouk. Because I was like, I hope I'm not butchering her. I don't want to butcher your name, girl. You eat every single time. Every single time I see a video or a picture of her on the runway, the way I've missed supermodels, bro. I feel like a lot of people have missed supermodels. I know there's a lot of like unhealthy practices when it comes to like the modeling industry in general, but I don't know, I feel like a lot of like my friends, a lot of people within the generation, or even people who like used to watch like shows like the Victoria's Secret fashion show in the past, miss these like big name supermodels, these icons, these like women sort of to look up to. And I'm, pause, we'll come back to that. Budget. I feel like the budget for this year's show was not there. She was lacking, especially in like the wings department. Some of the wings I did really like there was one butterfly wing which I thought was super pretty. I like the different incorporation of wings they try to do, like, and like show it in different styles. I thought that was really cool and creative, but a lot of the wings were lacking, and a lot of the models did not have wings. So I'm like, if the budget is not there, go for quality over quantity. So like at least the wings you do have, make sure they like are showing up, you know, especially since like this is your big entrance back. The hair, I miss the blowouts, guys. I do like the big natural hair. I was like, okay, I like that, you know, the black girlies out here representing. I love the big voluminous natural hair. However, I saw a lot of slick back ponies, which I don't mind. I like the Barbie look, you know? I'm a Barbie girl, but I do miss like the big voluminous blowouts that comes with the idea that you envision when you think of like a Victoria's Secret angel. So please, y'all, we're doing this again. I wanna see big hair on my girlies. Thank you. So in terms of the inclusivity that we see that Victoria's Secret is now trying to push, I'm still not sure if they hit the mark or not. Don't get me wrong, I do like the inclusion of the curve and plus size models. I feel like that was a very important thing that they were lacking, as well as trans models. Shout out to Alex. But I felt like they could have done a little more. But then it also makes me wonder that if they push it a little more, is it performative? Is what they're doing right now performative? I'm not sure. Y'all let me know, because I've been seeing a lot of like discussion on like Twitter about people like who are against the idea of including curve and plus size models into this brand, because like some people, I'm not gonna lie, I feel like it's kind of dumb. Because did y'all see Ashley Graham? She ate down. There was one model, I'm not quite sure what her name was, which I felt like her walk and the aura was kind of lacking, but it wasn't just shown within the curve models. There was also some like thinner models who also did not eat. There was this one model too, I'm sorry girl, I forgot your name, but she, like her walk, she, you know how that one meme that's like attitude, not walk off? She gave attitude, but in like the negative way, like the hip hop. I was like, oh. But you know, thing I think they did really excel on was the performances. The performances ate down. Tyla, she looked so good. She looked so cute. Her performance gave. Lisa, I think that's who she is, right? Lisa. Yes, Lisa from Blackpink. Oh, she is from Blackpink. Did she go solo? Okay, sorry. Lisa also ate. Their outfits ate down. Their performances ate down. And then also, who was the Ron Rock singer? Wait, apparently the person doing rock in the beginning was Cher. Cause I know Cher came in like at the end, but I'm like, I was trying to figure out who did that one's rock performance. That was Cher? Maybe I'm blind. Okay, it's fine. If it's not Cher, I'll insert her name, the person's name. What was I gonna say? Oh! Also, I kind of felt like there was no real theme for this year's show. Like, it felt like segments of different shows put together, which was like, okay. But since like a lot of like the outfits, I felt like they were lacking a bit. I felt like a theme maybe would have been nice to kind of just help pull the whole thing together. I do like miss the extravagance a bit, but that goes back to the whole budget thing, right? One thing I liked were the shoes. He had these butterfly shoes, which I thought looked really, really good. I was like, ooh, I might get those. Back to what I was saying about inclusivity. The one thing I wish they did have was more like ranges in terms of the ages of the models. I would have like, you know, someone, I would have loved to see someone who was like Cher's age, who like had, you know, the aura Cher has. Cher, like a legend. I feel like if there was a model that kind of looks like Cher that was walking, that would have ate down. Like more women her age, because I feel like older women tend to be neglected when it comes to this industry, and we don't really see them that much, because older women can still feel beautiful, they can still feel sexy, and they are, you know? So I'm like, if you're trying to rebrand yourself to be more inclusive, at least open up like the gaps in terms of ages. Speaking of ages, I do like that they brought back the like legendary models, you know? I do really like that they brought the legendary supermodels back. However, I did have a slight problem with Tyra Banks being there, because as we can see, Tyra Banks, she's now a grown woman. Her body has changed. She looks a bit different from what she did before, but she is the one model, especially on like, what was it, America's Next Top Model, who would hate on girls for being bigger, for having more weight, being more voluptuous. And now you're looking at her up on that runway, looking exactly like the woman that she hit it on. It makes me feel like, are y'all sure this was the right person y'all should put up on that stage? Let me know what y'all think. I feel like overall the show, I say it was a success. It was a success. I give them a B. Although they were missing elements of the past that would have helped amplify the show or just give it that little it was missing, I thought they did do a good job. It did bring back a lot of nostalgia. You know, it made me feel like, yo, I want to be up on stage. Give me a contract. But, you know, it, like, I feel like it made a lot of people who didn't really enjoy the shows really happy. And I think their brand is on a way to rebuild themselves, make themselves better, you know, try to be more inclusive. And there might also be like a shift that's occurring within the modeling and the fashion industry in general, which I'm really excited to see. That is it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know what y'all think in the comments, because, like, who do I talk to this about? Yeah, that's it. Bye.